recognize FDP. I'm very happy that within a few minutes that we got the 100% registration. So I know that the, you know, all people, all teachers are there very eager to understand the topic which we are going to discuss in next 7 days, that is e-learning and research management. There are 14 faculty members are there, 7 from our institute, and 7 there are experts from the industry. So I'm sure that next 7 days, it will be a very knowledgeable time for all of you, and we are going to gain a lot of knowledge and need of our. Bharati Vidyapeeth Institute of Management, which started in 1994 and known as one of the premier institute in Shivaji University area. We are affiliated, we are a constituent unit of Bharati Vidyapeeth deemed university, which is also A+ university, which has got a very good ranking. In last 5 years, we are in the best 100 universities at the NRF ranking. So I am very proud that we are a part of Bharati Vidyapeeth, and as a Bharati Vidyapeeth, we are doing a lot of such activities. Dear friends, I'm sure next 7 days, it will be a very important for all of you, and you are going to get a lot of knowledge. I request all of you, especially my colleague from Bharati Vidyapeeth, please take this all sessions very seriously, and you know, you should follow some of the ethics which are required when you are learning online. So I'm sure that you are going to cooperate, and the next 7 days, it will be memorable for all of you and for the institute also, because we are also learning. With this, once again, I wish you all the best. Have a great time. Have a knowledgeable time in the next 7 days. Once again, I thank my team, and also thank the participants. There are some principals from Bharati Vidyapeeth. There are director of the distance education, Dr. Savan sir. There is Dr. Nilima Bhore madam, Dr. Pooja Narodkar madam, Savate sir. All of you, thank you very much for joining. Have a great time. All the best.
Thank you so much, sir. Now we are closing the inaugural session. But before that, I want to thank everyone who have enabled the organization of this FDP. First of all, I want to thank our mentors, Honorable Chancellor Dr. Shivaji Rao Kadam sir, Honorable Pro Chancellor Dr. Vishwajit Kadam sir, and Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Manik Rao Salunke sir for their support and guidance. It helps us to continuously strive for academic excellence. I thank Dr. Nitin Nayak sir for his support. I thank all the staff members of IMRDA Sangli. And last but not the least, I thank all the participants who have enthusiastically joined this FDP and given tremendous response. Thank you, everyone. I declare this inaugural session is over. We will shortly begin our first technical session. For that, I hand over the charge of the session to Dr. R.S. Pujari, sir. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Myself, Dr. Rajendra Pujari, and I am here to introduce today's resource person for this session. The first session, the resource person is Dr. Prashant Patil, who will be talking about Google Forms customization. Dr. Prashant Patil graduated as an engineer. After that, he completed his MBA in operations management. Each subject area is research methodology and operations management and products. He also completed his PhD in management from Savitribai Phule Pune University and is currently working with Bharati Vidyapeeth Deemed to be University Institute of Management and Rural Development Administration since last 15 years. He has vast experience of more than 20 years. He worked with different organizations, different industry. I welcome and request him to start his session.
Good morning. Welcome all of you for this faculty development program and the first session which is on the Google Form. If I say that all of you have used Google Form at least once, then I'm not wrong. At least for filling up the registration form for this faculty development program, you have used this Google Form. Now you use that Google Form for filling up your information, but now we are going to see today here how to create the Google Form to get the information from others. Now there are many uses, applications and advantages of using Google Form. Basically, Google Form is used for the research survey. Also, it is used for education purpose, like conducting quiz test, and even with the short answer questions, you can conduct the test. For business sake, you can use Google Form to get the customer feedback, and to fill out order forms, you can use this Google Form. Now, the advantages of this Google Form is you can create unlimited free forms with Google templates. Templates are available. You can choose any template according to the suitability and you can use that Google Form. The result of this Google Form is shareable. Means when the respondent gives the response, he submits the forms, that information you can share with others. You can collaborate form with others. Suppose while creating the form, you want others' help, then you can seek that help with collaborating that form from others. We can get email notification for Google Form results. That is, when somebody submits the form, you can get informed of that submission in your Gmail account. Google Forms are mobile friendly. You can open up the Google Form there and can fill the Google Form and submit there in the mobile also. And therefore, you can ensure that a very high amount of response from the participants. So these are the different advantages and use of this Google Form. The basic requirement for this Google Form is to have an internet connection and a Gmail account. You must have to have a Gmail account to use this Google Form. Whenever, many of you know that there is no separate Google Form app like we see Google Doc app and Google Sheet app. There is no Google Form app. But yet you can use through browser. If you want to use Google Form in mobile, then you have to type docs.google.com/form in the browser and then you can open up the Google Form there. But it is easy to open it in PC. So you have to go to the Gmail account and there you can open it. So we are going to see how to open up and create a Google Form. So we'll take one example and then we'll see. Now I'm going to share the screen here for that. Click karna hai sir. This is my job. My screen here. So he minimized screen. So you have to open up the Google Drive. To open Google Forms on PC, go to the drive. Click the new button here, and then more. You have to go to the more, and then Google Forms. A blank form will be opened up as you are observing on the screen. Now, let us suppose you are a project manager and you are seeking information from your subordinates and team members. So, considering that theme, how we can develop a Google form practically, that we will see. Now, you would like to give heading to this. So now let us give the heading as P7. So this is our heading. Now we will start for framing the questions, that is to get information from the participants. So for that purpose, you have to press this button, add question, which is on the right side of your form. So press it. You will see a new field for placing your question. Now, normally the first information you want is name of the participants. So we can type here the name or your name like that you can write. So along with that, any field you can ask, there is position or the post that fellow is working, you can ask that. And here there is option like short answer, paragraph, multiple choice, but you want participants to write their name here. So you keep it here as a short answer. Now we can go for the creating the next field to get information. So again, you have to press it here. Normally, now the next thing you'd like to ask is their email address. So like that, you can see if the enable email collecting setting, if you keep it on, much more things will be automatized. So that will be the second, it will go first. Again, suppose this is the basic information you got from them. But again, suppose now you can create a next section to collect the information regarding your basic things, that is field work, about the work. So you can create the section. For creating section, you can go to this place. But prior to that, let us see how to add an image to this. You can add an image. So here is, there is option of image, add image, you can see here. Press it and you can get that image from your local device. For that purpose, you need to browse. Press the browse button and in the documents, I have saved this image for the project. So this I selected, opened. Now image will be there on the top of your Google form. And it came down, yet you can switch it. Shift it, but let us, it has been added because we have selected the question field. But to select, we can delete it because it is in the middle. We want it into the top, and I mistakenly selected the question field first and then I went to the image. So I will delete here. The delete icon is there. You can delete again. You can press here. Here there is customization theme. You can press that again. and the header option is there. You can choose image here. You can, if you want images from these fields, you can directly choose. But if your image has been stored on your local device, you need to press the upload, again the browse, and you can choose this one and open. Now here press done. And the image is on the top of this form now, you can see. So like that, the first page for getting the personal information of the participants or of the team members has been done. Now you can go for the page break. For the page break, you have to press this particular icon. See here, the thing is written add section. You can press this and can form the page break. See here, the page has been broken, and again you can give the title. You can give the suitable title. I have decided to give a title called as quantitative information because I want to collect some figure information from my teammates. Like that, you can type and give the heading. Now we are going to see framing the next question. So let us type some questions. The first question mine is percentage completion of assigned task by the end of June 30. So like that you frame. Now option is there whether you want a descriptive kind of thing or numericals. So suppose you want to get information in percentage with the difference of 10, so you can choose linear scale for the purpose. You have chosen linear scale, 10% to 100%, like that. If you want to keep, then keep one here, same 0 or 1 is the option. You keep 0% also you can keep. Then suppose you want up to 10, you can, if you place one here, the 10 will come like that. So label 1 will indicate 0% of work, or low you can name it as, and the 10% you can fully complete. You can mention here anything you can write there as you desire. So like that you can use this linear scale for getting information. Now we can go to the next question. So like this, it will be the participant will place their answer to any one of this circle. The next question can be, so on which date you have finished your 50% of work. So one thing you might have noticed, when you place the question like that and date, the artificial intelligence will come for your help, and month, day and year will be placed here. So you can get answer directly in the form of date here. So now we'll place the next question. Thank you. So what is earned value of your allotted task? So this is your question. Now you can expect them to write in numbers. Earned value are expressed in numbers. So you can place a number here. But suppose earned value, if you know something about earned value, it can from 0 to 2, you can say. Around 1 it is expected. So you can limit it. So for that purpose, suppose somebody writes 10 or 11, it is not viable or feasible. For that purpose, to get the correct answer from them, you can place the limitations. It is known as validation of the answers. For to make the validation, you need to go to this point. And there is a place here, response validation, which is on. And then you can place the number here between. You can place between. So you place from 0 and 2. So you can mention here 0 to 2. So the respondents have to figure their response between these. Then only it will be accepted or not. So like that you can form this question with the validation. Now suppose this quantitative information you got, now you want to have some descriptive information. We can name it as a qualitative information. So we can have again one more page break. You have to go for that purpose here. So you give heading here the qualitative info. Now the next question you can frame here by clicking this button. This is your question. Now we are expecting the answer, but the choices are available and you may would like to go for multiple choice. So options you can place here, that is low response or low cooperation. Another response can be a medium cooperation, high cooperation, like that. Three fields if you want to plus, you can, and go for the next question. So respondent has to choose from these three, one from these three. So next question is, the tracking of chart the tracking of Gantt chart helped communicate project. So options are again available. You can choose which one you would like to choose. I think tracking answers you may be expecting like no help to some extent, fairly help. Then again, you have to choose multiple choice, say no, sorry. put together. Okay. मैडम ने बोलो कुटी स्क्रीन के लिए अच्छा options So like that you have placed, suppose one more questions we can plus or two questions. Now suppose again options are available, then you can choose here the drop down. So first response can be I return, second so like that you can place on these things. The difference between this multiple choice question and drop down is that the respondent won't see all these alternatives. In the multiple choice, the respondent will see all these alternatives, but when you use drop down, it will save place and he will see the drop down arrow only. Now the next question we can place here. Place your opinion regarding your other peer department and how they are progressing. Now, you can use here the multiple choice grid. So different departments are there, and every department is performing differently, and you want to seek the peer's opinion for that. Then how we can do it here, you can write the departments here, like planning. Next department in your project organization can be procurement. Storage. One more department you can write. Liaisoning department. And the column you can plus, they are performing excellent. Good. Fair and poor. So in this session, you can form this question. So I think we have used many alternatives for framing the question, and this much questions are sufficient, I think. So it will look like this. The circles are there, and the respondent can choose any of these four for every department. So when such kind of situation is there, you have to use this multiple grid. Now we have typed all this, the questions for this survey or for this report, we can say. Now some of the fields you can make mandatory, and some of the fields you can keep optional for the respondent. Suppose name is a must thing, and what you can do here, email address as well as name, if you want to make it compulsory, press to this again and on this icon required, enable this field required. So email address automatically became mandatory because you enabled the setting there. That's why the star, you can see the star means you must have to attend, the respondent must have to attend this question. Without that, he can't go to the next page or can't submit this Google form. So like that, you can make it mandatory. Some of the questions also you can make mandatory, like this percentage completion of the assigned task, you can say it required. Like that you can do. So the star will come there. So like this question which you want to make participants attend, you can do that mandatory. So this is the framing. Again, suppose you want to shift the question, shuffle the question or change the position of the question, you can bring your browser here, cursor here, and you can do that. Suppose you want to bring it ahead. So like this, you can drag and place it here. This question will be the second last now, because previously last, now it became the second last. So like that, you can change the thing. So you can import the question as well. So there is a field, see here, the icon import. So what the import does here, if you want some questions from the other of the Google forms, which you already developed or created and which are on your same email account, Gmail account, then you can open up that particular and can bring it from there, question you would like to choose. Like that, it can, so you can import the question from the other Google forms which you have created. So for that purpose, you can use this particular icon. We have used this to bring the image from the other location. You can add the videos there, and this we have used, that is for breaking the page. Now like this, so we have formed this, created this Google form. Now you can use this responses setting and to get the responses. Once you send the Google form, this Google form will be available to your respondents, and then they will submit their filled forms. How to get that? if you don't enable this, then only you are going to get it. But if you enable this Google spreadsheet, create spreadsheet, then all the responses from the respondents will be collected in this Google sheet. So you, for that purpose, you need to make that enabled. So this is the form where the responses will come. Automatically it will be saved there. I will go to the questions again. We have used this one to give the title image. Again, you want to suppose change the background, then you can use this color theme. Can change like this and can make your form customized. You can go for the setting, and here are some options available. Now, limit to one response. Suppose you want your respondents to respond to that form only once, then you can enable this as one. Suppose you want them to give responses more than once, then you can disable this. By that, they can do it. Edit after submit. When you enable this, and suppose your respondent submits his form, but later if he feels that some corrections need to be done and he wants that particular correction to be done and then again sent to you, then if you want to allow them for that purpose, then you have to go for this setting, and previously only or before submitting the form, you have to keep it on. So like that, the options are available here. You can shuffle the question order, show link to submit another response. The things will be displayed there. Like that, you can make the same form turn into quizzes, especially for the educational purpose. If you want to grade, if you want to conduct the examination, then you can make this quiz on. When you make this quiz on, you have to grade the questions you have set. You have to give the grading from 1 to 1, 2, 3, 4, the giving of the marks grading means. So like that you can do and conduct the goal form as a examination paper to conduct the quizzes. So like that you can do. So again, we will go to the general setting. We have made edit after submit and collect email addresses. We can make it on. Limit to one response also we'll make it on. And thus we'll see here this thing. So this is how we have created the form. We can send this form, but before giving it, suppose you want confirmation message, you want to write, suppose you can write here it as a thank you for response. When the participant will submit the form, he will get this display, thank you for a response. If you want this, then you can write it here and you can create a save, and that thing will happen there. So this is how, what about creating the Google form. Now we can send it. Before that, I will show you some of the options. If you want to make a copy of this form which you have created, here the icon is there. You can create a copy in the same Google Drive account. So you can cancel it out. You can get a pre-filled link. This pre-filled link means, suppose you want to have certain information fixed from the respondent. You can type that information for a few of the fields, and then you can create and submit the form. For that purpose, this pre-filled link is there. You can get a print for collaborations. You can ask other people to come there. If you want to make some of the features change or additional features, then with this script editor programming, you can make it so. So these are the different fields available to make your Google form more useful. Some advanced features there. I will go for a send button here. Then for sending it, you need to have email addresses of the fellows to whom you want to send. So in the chat box, you can give me your Gmail addresses, which you can type here, but for temporarily, I can type my another Gmail account here so that I can show you the response coming. So I have typed one Gmail account and I can make a, can send it here. So here you can get a link of this form which you have created just now. So this is the link of the form. You can copy this link. See, it is highlighted. You have been copied to the clipboard. So for giving this particular form so that it can be utilized on WhatsApp, you have to go with this way. So now this copied link, what I can do, I can send it to my email itself. And I will send it to my itself, my email. Then I can download that particular, I can open that email in my mobile and I can download that and I can use, copy that, this link in the mobile and I can copy that in the WhatsApp field wherever you want to paste it. So like that you can do. So again, the email address, I have typed my email address and I can send it here. Now definitely would have, it would have gone now. I want to check it out. I need to open up the my second email account. Now this has come in promotion, let it be. Now this is the mail I got. In this fashion, you will get the Google form, or the participants to whom you submit or send will receive this Google form. To fill out the Google form, the participants have to press this and they can fill this Google form there. So I think this much is enough. So okay, I could show you this name of the participant was PSP, I'm writing here. And email address, suppose. Like that, if you can do. So if you plus the wrong email address, it won't go. So press it here, valid email address, like that it happens. See how to do that. So because this is mandatory and logically it will decide whether email address will be correct or not, and then only it will go forward. So these are the things we can do here while filling up the Google form. And when you send button, you can choose. It becomes quite easy. Suppose, if you remember, for this question, we had put the limitations. All validation was active. Suppose now you answer it as a 4. You'll see here must be number between 0 and 2, because while framing this question, you enabled the validation. So which was between 0 to 2 or 1 to 2. So I don't remember. So this, let us put 1.4 and check it out. Yes, it is accepted. So now we can go to the next field. Give your opinion regarding cooperation among team members. Say medium here. Whether the tracking, whether the investment made on the project will be give a satisfactory return. See here the drop box which we created CAM. You can choose any. So you need to choose. So if you want to choose two, it is not possible because they are not check boxes. In the check box, you can check many boxes. So this is the difference between check box and this multiple choice. So like that, you have filled the form and you can submit this form. Thank you for your response, which we typed while creating the form. So like that, we have done here. See, now I opened my mailbox or the Google Drive where I created the form and sent it. Now you have, see here, one response we have received, which I sent just now. So this is the response I have received. That response you can see here. And you enable this thing so you can see the information which you received from this mail. PSP I sent from my second account. So you can see here like this, the information you can collect. These are the responses which I filled while responding this Google form. So like that, you can collect the information from the respondents. So like this, I think I have made this presentation from my side over. Now I'll hand over to the Pujari sir. If there are some queries, you can ask. I'll try to address that.
This session is open for some question answers and some queries received from. All of these are not processed because of time limit, but some of the queries are very interesting one, and those is whether only Gmail account holders can make and respond Google Forms. Yes, sir.
Yes, any Gmail account you can use.
I use my second account, which is a company's account, you can say. PSV at the rate VVIMS, not directly a Gmail account. But the organizer has to be enabled that setting so that you can use that. So then you can use it.
Second question from Santosh Asuri. Sir, if it's possible to send one link to WhatsApp to 300 structured respondents. And sir, please guide me about how to change the English format.
Yes, you can send link by copying it. So only limitation is that limitation of your Google Drive's memory. So you can go for 300, 400, even 1000 submissions you can do. but your memory should not exceed Google Drive's memory. That is the only limitation.
Next question from Madhura Mane. Can we get information in table format?
Table format is also possible, but again you have to go for the script and
Google form.
Next question is how to add.
आपका तो वीडियो और वो नहीं आ रहा है दोनों. आपके नाम पे कुछ भी नहीं है. तो उसमें भी साउंड कुछ भी नहीं आ रहा है.
Using file upload you can do that.
वो प्रवीण सर ने क्वेश्चन पूछा है उसका हाउ टू क्रिएट सर्टिफिकेट.
हाउ टू ऐड डायग्रामेटिक क्वेश्चंस.
डायग्रामेटिक क्वेश्चंस यू कैन प्रिपेयर द क्वेश्चंस एज अ इमेज एंड देन अपलोड
इट. लास्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ टू रिस्ट्रिक्ट टाइम लिमिट टू फिल अप द फॉर्म्स.
यू कैन वैलिडेट इनेबल वैलिडेशन एंड कैन डू दैट.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Now all questions are not processed at same time. So that.
Okay, later on you give your queries on email. Email address.
Sir, process all queries with email ID. Please sir, share your email ID with all the participants. Mm-hmm. And thank you for conducting this session. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. My email address will be shared. Thank you.
Now we declare that this meeting is over. Thank you, participants. We will join at sharp 1 o'clock for second session on Google Classroom by Professor Dr. B. D. Patil. Thank you.